The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, how are you today? I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to talk about nasal bleed. So what causes these nosebleed? What is the reason? Is it trauma? Is it high blood pressure? Is it something else? Is it an allergy? Is it an irritation? Quite frankly, it needs to be understood, right? See, nasal bleed is the basic bleeding from the lining of the internal mucus of the nose, right? Most often it occurs from either one of the nostrils, right? It has to be. And it is very common. It mostly occurs more in winters, but it can occur anytime. The most common reason of nasal bleed are minor irritations or cold, and cold can happen in winter as well as in summers, right? See, nose basically contains many small minute blood vessels that can bleed easily, and because air is continuously moving through the nose, the internal mucosa can become dry, and that air and even any kind of dust particles can actually irritate the internal lining of the nose, and even the mucosa can become hard and crust can form inside the nose, and these crust can move and irritate, and you can even pick this crust and that might even cause an injury and bleed, right? And winters are more common, these problems are more common in winter because of the cold viruses that are more common in winters, and indoor air in winters are more dry, and that's one of the reasons. See, most of the times nasal bleeding happens in the septum, in the middle septum, that too in the anterior part, which is actually the commonest type and is easy to control, quite frankly. But less commonly, bleeding can happen from the upper parts, back, deeper upper parts, and that time it is little difficult to control, and very rarely nasal bleeding can be life threatening, right? So what are the causes? We already seen that irritations like due to allergies, cold can lead to these problems. Even sneezing and sinus problems can lead to nasal bleeding. Very cold or very dry air can lead to nasal bleeding. Blowing the nose very hard or picking the nose is one of the reason. Then injury to the nose, including a broken nose or an object stuck into the nose, or maybe a sinus or pituitary surgery anywhere close to the nose, deviated nasal septum can increase your chances of these bleedings. Sometimes chemical irritants like medicines which you are taking through the nose, some nasal sprays or some other nebulizers or snorted medicines, they can cause irritations, right? Overuse of decongestant nasal sprays can also cause problems. See, decongestant can help in treatment also, but using them over a long time can lead to nasal bleeding as well. Oxygen therapy through nasal prong, nasal cannulas can also lead to nasal bleeding because of injuries. And if you have repeated nasal bleeds, then you have to think about some other bleeding disorders or high blood pressure, or sometimes there is a tumor inside a nose or the sinus which is actually bleeding. So bleeding disorders can be because of liver disease, can be because of blood thinners which you are taking, maybe clopidogrel, aspirin, warfarin. So all these things needs to be considered to see what is causing nasal bleed. But how to stop nasal bleed? By yourself, what you can do, if you are having a nasal bleed, gently sit down, relax, and gently squeeze the soft portion of the nose between your thumb and this finger, and here you have to, so that both the nostrils are closed, and you have to do this for 10 minutes. Meanwhile, you will breathe from the mouth. 10 minutes, full 10 minutes. Don't leave before that, and allow proper time, enough time for the bleeding to stop, at least 10 minutes. And then you have to lean forward so that whatever bleeding is happening and whatever has happened does not actually go back into your windpipe or your food pipe. So you have to lean forward so that if it can come out once and then squeeze it. So then while squeezing, you can actually apply, after squeezing, you can apply a little ice or cold compression over the bridge of the nose. Do not pack inside of the nose with gauze or even ice, nothing you should put inside, right? It's not recommended to lie down. Don't lie down, that can again increase the bleed to go inside your mouth or into your airways. do not sniff or do not blow your nose for several hours after a nasal bleed. And if the bleeding persists, then you can use a nasal decongestant spray also, and that can actually sometimes close small blood vessels and control the bleeding. But don't use it over a week or more than a week, because it can increase your frequency of bleeding as well. Then you need to think about if you have recurrent bleeding, then you have to do some changes at your home. Number one, you have to make sure that your home is cool, and you have to use a vaporizer in the home to keep the air moist. It might be very dry. Second, you have to use a nasal saline spray or saline drops or water soluble jelly to make sure to prevent that, to make sure your nasal inner lining is not dry, to prevent these kind of issues in winter as well as in summers. When to go to a doctor? If your bleeding does not stop even after 20 minutes, or if it is increasing, or if you had a nasal injury or nose injury or any surgery and then you are having a bleeding, then you need to go to a doctor straightforward. If there is a child who is having a bleeding, go to a doctor straightforward. Make sure that you don't waste time in such cases. If you go to the doctor, many tests will be done. The best doctor for this kind of situation is an ENT specialist. And they might do a packing of the nose for temporary basis and do your blood test to check out for problems, bleeding disorders. Nasal endoscopy can be done, coagulation profile can be done, CT and X-ray can be done of the nasal paranasal sinuses, etc., etc. So it's very important to control the blood pressure also at that time, or even nasal. If there is a broken bone, then you might need a surgery, you might need fixing of it. So there, the management depends upon the cause. Obviously, for that you need to go to a doctor. So this is all about nasal bleed, which you need to know. I hope you enjoyed the session, the lecture. Don't forget to share this video and let me know your comments. And I'm Dr. Paranjit. You're watching Dr. Education. Stay connected, stay healthy. See you next time.